Now we're going to continue on with our plastic text. What we're going to do here is we're going to reach up and hold down our command key and go right over our text here and select it like so. Now, as you can see, we've selected our text here. What we're going to do is we're going to come over here into our channels layer and save selection channel that we've used here. So what we're going to do is we're going to use our alpha channel here that we've just created from our selection, like so. What we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and let's just go ahead and let's go to filter, let's go to blur. What we're going to do is we're going to Gaussian blur this quite a bit. Let's go up to 9. Oops, just delete that. There we go. What we're going to do is we're going to do that again. Let's go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. We're just going to keep on going down the line here. We'll do 6 next. Let's go to filter, blur. Let's do Gaussian blur. Let's go down to 3. And let's do one more just for good measure. Filter, blur. Let's do Gaussian blur again, and we'll take it down to 1. There we go. Now we have a nice faded edge on our selection here. So let's Command-D select this, or Command-D to deselect it. And there we have it. What we're going to do here is we're going to come back here and touch our plastic text like we have here. And we're going to go ahead and add a lighting effect to this. So we'll pause here, and we'll actually do our lighting effect in our next section.